Hey everyone, how's it going? It's been a while. Anyway, today we had our first bit of snow, and I thought I'd come out to one of the local cemeteries and do some videoing and photographing. I just love it when there's a slight dusting of snow on top of the tombstones. There's some really excellent photographs to take. I'm actually in Barry Union Cemetery. Now, this is a non-denominational cemetery that's been established around 1860 something. I'll have to check on the date. It's still a cemetery that is in use today, so we'll be very respectful of that. There's some really nice old tombstones here and mausoleums. One or two mausoleums I can see. There's a memorial chapel. I'm just going to swing you around so you can take a look. There we go. So as you see, we've got a bit of a dusting. Not much. Just enough. Just enough to make it, I don't know, special. Down there by the Canadian flag, you can see the veterans section. It's a really beautiful veterans section, and we're coming up to November the 11th. So I'd like to take some photographs of that as well. So you're probably going to see more photographs in this video than you are actually videos. So why don't we get to it? Can you see it by that garbage can? That's a crypt liner, a grave liner. Not sure what it's doing out there, but I thought it was a box for sand for the roadway, but it's not. It's actual grave liner. And there's the maintenance guy. Okay, we're going to move on. Okay, so here we are. And I believe the name is Plower. Plower? I could be wrong if I'm mispronouncing it. I do apologize. There's another crypt at the back here. And see, all the graves here are all in these terraces. See down here? They're all in these terraces. This keeps everything nice and neat. It's just so quiet and peaceful here. Let's take a round look here on the other side. Here's another one. Let me just... Bird. Is this, mausoleum again. Just be careful where I want. We got a double door here. We got the bars as well as an iron door. And judging by the looks of all those leaves down there, it hasn't been accessed for many years. There's the memorial chapel over there. All right. Got a beautiful columbarium here. The Last Supper. For cremation niches. There's the door to the chapel right there. It is in use, I believe. It's used purely for memorial services. But that is... This is fairly modern, too. Thank you. Well, there's a really old one I missed here. 1875. We got a few of them down here. Looks like something out of A Christmas Carol right now. Incredible. Really is. There's another very old marker there. Oops, don't mean to. Right there. See if I can get a bit closer to it. I gotta be careful where I'm stepping because I can't see where the plot markers are. I'll let you know if I fall, okay? Here's a closer shot of this one. I think the date on here is 1850 something. It's not very legible, but you can see, look at the lichen on the bottom of the monument here along the base. It's pretty thick, so yeah, it's been here a while. Almost like a Celtic cross, but it's not. Silhouetted in the snow. Come across a white bronze marker for Rogers. The date on it is 1887. It's beautifully preserved. Bronze markers usually are by, though. And at the top we've got this statue. I'm not quite sure who it represents. But, just gorgeous. Some of them end up with these panels broken out as they're put in after, specifically for what the family want. And they, for some reason, go missing. I think this one's got all of them. Look, quite is a relief here. I'm having a hard time standing in this snow. Not a lot, but it's enough. Son of Richard and Edith. Yeah, he wasn't very old, a year. That's probably what this cherub represents, is that of a child. So here's the other side. Seems to be the burials of two children, one at 4 years of age and one at one. But it's obviously a family marker. We got the wheat sheaf on this side. It's completely intact, no damage whatsoever. That's good. It's the way they should all be. Just pristine. Just came across these beautifully carved monuments. We've got an angel here. These are carved out of tree trunks. And at the back we have what appears to be an eagle. Yeah. Covered in snow. Gorgeous. And we have another mausoleum. We'll take a walk around there. So let me get some photographs of these two here. There's a few more mausoleums just down here. This is a huge cemetery. I didn't realize it was that big. So we'll go down there and have a look as well in a minute. So here's one of the other mausoleums, and by the looks of things, it only has one occupant, Webb. I'm not sure, I can't read the first name, it's a little difficult, but the other panel over here, that panel there, is blank. 1926 was the interment. Hmm. So here's the other one. McKnight and Guthrie, I think the name's on here. Metcalf. Buckman. Hasn't been any entombments in there for a while. The door is completely sealed off. It's just cemented completely over. So I guess it's got all its occupants in there. Looks like maybe about 6 people are entombed, I should say, in that. Seen better days too, that one. A lot of cracking on the sides here. Looks like the last entombment was about 1974. So I wanted to stop here because this is where some very old headstones appear to be. There's a couple of modern ones in here, I guess family burials, but just wanted to come over and have a look. I'm getting a bit chilled out here. A squirrel running up that tree down there. Just take a look over here. I can't get close to a lot of the graves. There's an interesting one over here. Because there's snow on the ground and I can't see what's under the snow. There's probably plot markers and goodness knows what else. And I just have to be careful. I don't have the greatest of balance. Oh, here we go. Looks like a lantern almost. I don't know if you can see it here in the camera, but the inscription is covered by a glass plate. Unfortunately, there's some mold on the plate, so I can't really tell what year, death year, but it's for Samuel Tracy. Could be 1880 something. Gone but not forgotten, I can make that much out. And it appears to be a zinc marker or some form of copper. Huh. I got some very old burials down here. These are going back into the mid-1800s, these ones. Again, just have to be careful on my footing. Sorry that I keep saying that, but when you get to be my age, walking around cemeteries. You tell the difference between the old cemetery and the new one. The new one is so organized and it's surveyed, so the graves are in nice neat lines and terraces. And here we've got the pioneer burials in this cemetery. And you can see they're kind of higgledy-piggledy. Now some of them, of course, that the headstones are lying flat, which gives the illusion that they're not even lines. We've got a veterans burial over here. I'm going to take a look at that. This is probably the cemetery that was here prior to this being established as the non-denominational cemetery. So here's that veterans burial, and it's Private A.D. McMillan, 27th Battalion, the Canadian Expeditionary Forces, January the 10th, 1942, so it's Second World War. It's so peaceful here. There's a light snow falling and I'm getting a little wet and cold right now, so I think we're gonna go off and get something hot to eat. I got quite a lot of pictures and videos. I'm gonna have to come back here again and walk around when you can. I don't think I'll be able to do it until next year, until the spring, but there are some really fascinating graves in here, old ones along with new. It's in a huge cemetery, it just is, and it's just beautiful and so quiet in here. This is why I love walking around these places. It's just that they're wonderful places for reflection. They really are. So, anyway, every time I look around, I see something fascinating. But anyway, I'm going to sign off for now. So this is Sharon getting her fix in the first snowfall of 2019. And remember, if you come out to these places, remember what I keep telling you. Show respect. Please, please show respect. Take only pictures and leave only footprints. Bye for now.